This is an 1875 Steeple type compound marine steam engine built by the King Ironworks in Buffalo, New York. I'm Darren, and this is the Industrial Revolution. The first thing that really stands out about marine steam engines, as opposed to practically every other steam engine you've ever seen, is that they're built vertically instead of horizontally. There's very limited space on cargo ships, and every square foot that you give to the engine is a square foot you're taking away from cargo, and that means less money. That means that steam engines that went onto cargo ships were built tall and as small as possible to maintain stability. The whole purpose of the steam engine, of course, is down here. This is your propeller shaft. This is why you have your steam engine in the first place. So everything is based upon driving this propeller shaft. Although in this case, and most others, you also had some additional capabilities off of your steam engine. For example, you had this pump over here on the side, probably used as a bilge pump. So this engine actually spent time on two ships. It started off in 1875 on the Great Lakes Steamer Portage and lasted there till 1903. In 1914, it was moved to the Great Lakes Steamer Romania, where it stayed installed until 1926, finally being removed. So this particular engine provided 400 horsepower, running 72 RPM max with a 36-inch stroke. It's a compound steam engine, and you can see at the very top of the engine here. The upper cylinder was a high-pressure steam, and that was a 26-inch diameter cylinder. Below it is the much larger cylinder, and that ran low-pressure steam at 54-inch diameter. The high-pressure steam from the upper cylinder vented into the lower cylinder, and that allowed you to use the steam twice at no extra cost. It's commonly used on railroads and on more advanced steam engines until really steam engines went out of favor. So though marine steam engines may look a little bit different, realistically they do exactly the same thing as every other steam engine out there. The valves, the connecting rods, everything that's there, the gearing, it's all there. It works the same way as it works on a locomotive. It's just a little more vertical and a little bit bigger than most of them. So despite those differences, really steam lasted in the ship world probably longer than it did in the rail world. And there's still some steam engines out there, although most of them now are running either diesel or fuel oil. But this was really the beginning of a steam-powered, non-sail-powered ship navigation. And that's why this is the Industrial Revolution. Hey, before you go, I do need your help to keep this channel going and also to help keep it growing. The easiest thing you can do to help is just to click the like button. Also, if you can do subscribe and notify, then you'll know when I release new videos and you'll be able to watch those. Also, I have a Patreon page over at patreon.com/industrialrevolution. And if you have any questions, comments, places you think I should go visit, please leave those down in the comments section of the video. That's actually the best way to tell YouTube, hey, this is a channel worth watching. Thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you at the next one.